We all talk. Let me ask you a question. Do you know how many words you speak every day? Take a guess. 1,000 words? 2,000 words? Typically, you speak 10,000 to 20,000 words a day. Well, it depends on how talkative you are. In your lifetime, you may speak 400 to 800 million words. What does it mean? It's like speaking the entire 32-volume Encyclopedia Britannica 20 times in a row. Well, I hope you are also listening. So you may hear about 1 to 2 billion words in your lifetime. Well, if you're 30 years or 40 years old right now, 99.99% of your voice data is never saved. If we look at the human history level, more than human appeared about 300,000 years ago. They probably developed some kind of a voice communication to talk to each other. However, it's all words of mouth. Nothing is saved to pass around to the next generation. Until about 5,000 years ago, some written languages developed so that you can write down things and pass information to the next generation. But we never heard from Shakespeare. We never heard from Charles Darwin until Thomas Edison invented a voice recorder about 1877, which started a huge revolution. It enabled telephone, enabled, well, video conferencing now, and audiobooks. But for hundreds of thousands of years, all the voice knowledge and intelligence is lost. So today I'm going to talk about meeting problems in modern work and how AI will solve these problems. And at the end, I'm going to ask a question about avatar. I'll talk about what avatar is. So I guess everybody is familiar with this picture. Before 2020, we already have a lot of meetings in person and audio conferences. And then COVID happened. We suddenly started to schedule a lot of video conferences. The invention of Zoom made it so easy to schedule video conference. And it's so easy to add a lot more people to them. So typically, a knowledge worker spends 30 to 55% of their time in meetings. If you're a manager, you may spend more than 20 hours or 30 hours in meetings. About 30% of those meetings are actually unnecessary. So not only they're causing a lot of fatigue, they're also very costly financially. So if 30% of the meetings are unnecessary, that means that each company is paying each employee about $20,000 to go to unnecessary meetings. If your company has 500 people, it costs about $10 million to pay people to go to unnecessary meetings. With all these meetings, how much can you remember? Actually, not much. Within the week, you're going to forget 90% of the information. If you don't remember the information, how are you going to communicate and share that information with your colleague who didn't attend those meetings? Not very well. So that caused a lot of information silos and miscommunication. Each team may now know what the other team is currently doing. Well, if you're in a startup, you know, we're in a startup, things change so fast, right? Miscommunication and misalignment happen. So that caused a vicious cycle because with all the miscommunication, you need to schedule more meetings to solve those problems, which cause more fatigue. So how AI can change the way we meet and work? Now with AI, you can actually capture almost all the voice communication. So that's at least solved the memory problem. And then with search and AI chat, you should be able to use chat to query your company's entire meeting database if they're shared and made accessible to everyone. Suppose, right, you're curious about customer calls. You can ask, hey, what are the common customer requirements from last week's sales calls? In our company, actually, we make all our sales calls available to everyone in the company. So everyone knows what the customers need and what their pain points are. Again, AI can make all the meetings easily shareable. You can go to the marketing channel to see what the marketing teams are discussing. You can go to the sales channel to see what customers are talking about. Or you can go to the engineering channel to see what the engineering teams are discussing, what challenging problems are they solving. This will enable radical transparency in corporations. This is actually what Jensen Huang has been advocating. One reason NVIDIA is so effective is that Jensen wants all meetings to be open. Ideally, if they use a system that enables all meetings to be shared, that will make that radical transparency work even better. We're all familiar with ChatGPT these days. On the left-hand side, that's a ChatGPT's model. It's a one-on-one chat model between a human being and a robot. Actually, there is a more powerful model. On the right-hand side, you can enable a collaborative AI chat model that enables AI to participate in group communication. It's not just one-on-one. You can have a meeting with the CEO, the product managers, the marketing managers, and AI can participate in that meeting, either asynchronously or synchronously in a real-time meeting. So we see that's a much more powerful model than the current one-on-one ChatGPT model. This will enable a whole new communication system. If you think about telephone and Zoom, it's basically just passing sound wave around. It actually doesn't do anything with the content you talk about. With this new AI system, it actually can transcribe, summarize, and analyze the content in real time. AI will be present in every communication system to make your meetings and conversations much more valuable. Suppose you're talking to a customer and the customer raised some serious objection to your product and you don't know how to answer. Well, AI is listening. It can give you some suggestions even in real time. It makes your conversations much more intelligent. So we just talked about how AI can help company at the corporate level, but how does it make everyone more effective? One thing we can do is actually we can create an avatar for everyone. What does it mean? Well, if you give your knowledge to AI, we can use that to train the model with your brain dump. All the documents you wrote, all the emails you wrote, all the Slack messages, all the meetings you had in the past, we can train a model that has your knowledge, your opinion, and your preference, and can just talk like you. Suppose you're sick in the morning, you cannot attend the stand-up meeting. You can send your avatar to attend the meeting. You give your update and can answer questions. Well, if you're on vacation, your avatar can attend a lot of meetings for you. If you're a recruiting manager, you have 1,000 candidates to screen. How can you do that so fast? Your avatar can call those candidates and screen 1,000 candidates in a day. I was joking with our board that someday, you know, we don't have to have a board meeting. We just have our avatars have the board meeting and all of us just go to the bar and have a drink. Personally, well, you don't want to call the United Airlines to resolve any problem. You just have your avatar to call them. Also, you know, once in a while, actually, I need to call my credit card company to dispute a charge, right? They usually put me on hold for 10, 20 minutes. Well, I can just tell my avatar to do that for me. So of course, there's a lot of challenges to build avatars. Not only you need to have the knowledge, you also need to train the system to have emotional intelligence, right? The avatar can join the meeting. It needs to be able to observe how other people are responding to questions or answers. So it needs to be multimodal. It needs to understand when to start talking, when to interrupt, or when to just stay calm. So your avatar actually will be a better you. It can behave even more intelligent than you. It may not get angry too fast. So let's put your work on AI, put your life on AI. Let's work together to make this happen. Thank you.